Super Bowl weekend, Saints versus the Colts. I am just psyched. And as promised, I have the Super Bowl predictions on who's going to win for the year. Now, you know, I know a lot of my friends were like, what? You don't watch football that much. Well, yes, I do. I like football. I'm a Cardinals fan. Of course, I've been watching football this year. But they say there's no way I'm going to let a girl decide who I'm going to put money on for the game. Well, you know, from a medical perspective, y'all may want to listen to this because I think I've predicted who's going to win the Super Bowl tomorrow just from the medical statistics alone. Okay. Now, I got my information here from the, I think it's the NFL site injury report. Okay. Now, you that probably means a lot more to you guys than me. This looks like a list of injuries, and I'm taking a look right now at the type of injuries the Saints had and what put the players out this season and the Colts. All right. Now you see a lot of elbow injuries and hand injuries and shoulder and ankle. And, you know, these orthopedic injuries can really be an issue, especially since the game is going to be played in South Florida and with all the humidity. So, you know, we really should do kind of a cross-sectional analysis of who has what orthopedic injury and who's not going to do well with the humidity. But there is nothing more devastating to an NFL player, right? Nothing more devastating to the game than a groin injury. So what we did is we filtered out all these other injuries that these players had, and we took a look at who got their groin attacked during these games, okay? Now, I know people are like, nah, groin injury is not that bad. I think it is. Now, true, I don't have a groin. I don't have testicles. But if I did have a testicle, well, I mean, I know it'd be more realistic to have two testicles than one, but I let's just say, if I had a testicle and it got sacked in a football game, I don't think I could play football, let alone hold the ball. So as far as I'm concerned, the groin injury is the worst. Okay, so if we take a look at the New Orleans Saints, all right, and we see who had a groin injury, Jabari Greer. Oh, he sounds like a nice fella. He had, looks like, a groin injury that put him out January 29th. He also had one in January 1st. Boy, his groin kind of is getting injured a lot this season. 12-25, 12-18. He's got to get his groin out of the way. All right. So it looks like Jabari Greer is the big groin victim of the Saints. But when we take a look at the Colts, okay, if we take a look at the Colts, we have here Irvin Baldwin, who had a groin injury January 15th that put him out. Now Peyton Manning, he only had a glute injury. I'm sure we can massage that out and he'll be fine. So Peyton Manning will be fine. Reggie Wayne had a groin injury, right? And Gerard Powers had a groin injury. So if we just take a look at the science here, right? The Saints, only one person had a groin injury. The Colts, Will Smith. Will Smith apparently must have joined the Saints, and he had a groin injury too. I didn't know Will Smith played. But anyway, Will Smith had a groin injury too on the Saints. So if we take a look, that's two groin injuries for the Saints, three groin injuries for the Colts. The Colts are not going to win. I'm sorry, guys. Looks like the Saints are going to win tomorrow. Now, I'm not excited by this prediction at all, because remember, the Saints are the ones that knocked out the Cardinals earlier this season. So I am not happy about this, but look, we've got to look at the science, right? The Saints are probably going to win this. I'm sorry. Now, I hope my husband's listening so he goes and makes a bed. We are going to have to put money on the Saints. Yes, I am more of a Colts fan than a Saints, especially since I really like their colors more. But I'm sorry. Guys, that's the science of it all. Saints are going to win tomorrow. Okay.